I grew up in the church. My parents, you know, I mean, they grew up in the church. So I would say I was spiritual, if that makes sense. But I allowed certain things to go on. I did certain things in my life, whether it was sex or drugs, stuff like that, in clubs, strip clubs, and was totally comfortable in those environments and my friends, you know, being with them. I just was like, hey, I'm a Christian. I believe in God. And, you know, I'm just having a little fun. I was no stranger of Jesus, but just hadn't committed to Jesus. You know what I'm saying? And I heard somebody say that, you know, acknowledging Christ doesn't make you a Christian. Making him Lord over your life does. I actually got saved in 2007. And it was in a Waffle House, actually, in Maryland. I know, it's kind of weird. But the pastor, he said, hey, it was me and another gentleman that we were coming back from school that year, that summer. And so he said, I want to meet with you guys. Let's go to Waffle House, get some breakfast, and let's just kind of talk about your walk with Christ. He got there, and he just kind of laid it on thick, if I'm just honest. He was just like, man, you know, you're living this life, and although you're doing it, you're living a good life. Good people go to hell. You know, you need to be living a saved life. For me, like in knowing in Christ that, hey, no matter what I have going on, he's always there with me. You know, I can't tell you whether he's working for you or what he's done for you, but I can only say what he's done for me. Jesus dying on the cross for my sins, you know, just to allow me the opportunity to see God's face. That is the greatest gift. That's the greatest gift that could ever be given. So for me, I see him a lot, and this is not a cheesy answer, I see him a lot in my wife. We met in college, and I would call her sometimes, and, hey, what are you doing? And, you know, it's 8:30, you know, I'm getting ready to go to cafeteria for breakfast or something like that. And she's like, I'm reading my daily devotional. I'm like, man, you reading your daily devotional? Like, okay. And so then after a while, after hearing that so many times, I'm like, why don't you give me one of those daily devotionals? Let me see what it's talking about. I credit her for a big portion of my walk getting close. I realize that even as a saved individual, as a minister, I still fall short every single day. But the difference is understanding that I have somebody I can go to, and they're not judging me because of that. They're saying, hey, I saw you fall. Come on, let's get back up and let's get back on the right track. And I've never met anybody that said, man, when I gave my life to Christ, that's when everything started going downhill. I've never known anybody to say that. I'm Bobby Matthews, and he changed my life.